What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. And today, we have a what if. We got a college football what if. What if Randy Moss played football at Florida Sate? Now, I got some facts to the story. I might not have all the facts correct. So if I'm wrong, hey, just let me know down in the comment section below. But Randy Moss was arguably one of the best college football players, high school football players ever. High school, right? That's what Coach Lou Holtz said when he was back playing high school football, when Lou Holtz was the coach at Notre Dame. Randy Moss wanted to play football at Notre Dame, and of course they gave him a scholarship because this man was a beast in high school. But he got into some legal issues as a teenager in high school, and eventually Notre Dame would revoke the scholarship offer. But good old Bobby Bowden at Florida State was like, hey, we dealt with guys like you in the past. We're going to give you a scholarship, but we have to redshirt you, right? They had to redshirt him because he signed his letter of intent with Notre Dame. The NCAA was like, we're not just going to let you play right off the bat, all right? Now, one thing I forgot to mention that Bobby Bowden also said that Randy Moss was a bigger version of Deion Sanders. And, of course, Deion Sanders is Bobby Bowden's measuring stick when it comes to being an athlete. His words, not mine. Back to the video. So, he would have had to wait a year, and then he would have played during the 1996 college football season, 1997 college football season, and then, of course, eventually move on to the draft like he did in real life. Because if you remember, he played for Marshall during the 1997 year, and that was his only statistical season in college football. Now, the reason why he didn't stick around Florida State is because when he was still dealing with one of his legal issues from the past, he got caught with marijuana in his system, failed the drug test, and eventually Florida State had to revoke the scholarship. Now, during the 1996 season, Florida State played Florida in what might have been the greatest year of this rivalry. They played the last week of the season, which they do almost every single season. Florida State got the win. At the time, Florida was the number one team in the country. Florida State was the number two team in the country. Later on that season, in the Sugar Bowl, they will face each other again. This time, Florida State being the number one team, Florida being the number three team, it would basically be the national championship game. Whoever won this game was going to be crowned a national title, was going to be crowned a national champion, because back then they didn't have a national championship game. Now, this game was epic. If you ever saw it, you are as old as me probably. But at the end of the day, man, Florida State ended up losing that game to Florida, which was the rematch. Now, their starting quarterback was Thad Busby, who is on your screen right here, and good old NCAA 14. He was a starting quarterback. He would have a decent junior season, which was 1996, 1997. He would have a better senior season. His main target, even though he was just a freshman, was Peter Warrick. At this point, Randy Moss would have been a sophomore, and he would also be on this team. Peter Warrick, one of the most elusive receivers in college football history. I mean, the dude was bad to the bone. He was a fourth overall pick in the draft. I believe it was the 2000 draft. And of course, you have Warrick Dunn, who was a senior running back for Florida State, who at the time would go down as the number one leading rusher in Florida State history. Of course, that title belongs to Delvin Cook now, I believe. Or is it Freeman? Y'all correct me if I'm wrong. Is that a Cook or Freeman? I believe it's Cook, though. But I could be wrong. Anyways, though, man, this is the squad. We got Randy Moss, the big boss, Peter Warrick, got Thad Busby, and Warrick Dunn. And you can see we are freaking just bending people over, man. Excuse my language, but we are just taking it to people. As you can see, we are 11-0 right before our game versus Florida. Now, again, that 1996 game was epic. And, of course, I believe the first game was close. But then the championship game, even though it was just the Sugar Bowl, wasn't really the championship game. Florida would end up blowing out Florida State for the 1996 national title. And I believe that was their first national title. So we can put up points with the best of them. And now it's time to take on Florida. So here it is, baby, the game. And we got Warrick Dunn on the screen pass. He's going to turn upfield, and he's going to pick up a solid gain of 10. But they do not give him the first down. So on third and inches, we go up, die, guy. And Warrick Dunn picks it up. Move those chains. So third down and 10. Busby got the big boss, Randy Moss, making people miss, headed down the sideline, and that's a gain of 43. And then on third down and 10, give it to him again on the slant route, and now we're going to move to the second quarter of play. It's a 7-6 ball game, and we're going to take it all the way with work done. Now, for this little dynasty, I was just playing as the offensive coordinator. I ain't had too much time to play defense. I'm just letting you know. So we're back on offense, Peter Warrick. I mean, if you haven't seen Peter Warrick's highlights, what's wrong with you? Like, seriously, you got to see this man's highlights when he was at Florida State. The man was a freaking glitch, man. He was a joystick. Anyway, second down and 10, we get the ball to Warrick Dunn, Mr. Reliable, and he's going to pick up a game of 9. Third down and 1 now under some pressure. Randy Moss, the big ball, strikes again. Gain of 11 and a fresh set of downs. Now Busby over the middle, going to find Dunn as well. And Dunn for a gain of 14, picks up another first down. Can't step the screen pass, and Dunn gets loose. Look at the moves. Oh, my goodness. Headed to the corner of the end zone. Touchdown, Florida State. Let's move to the third quarter, y'all. Busby looking down. Field going to drop it off to Warrick Dunn. He's been doing it all, man. He's been catching the ball out of the backfield, but running through the tackles. He's been doing everything for us. Taking a shot up top on third down, and that shot up top goes nowhere, just to the ground. So on 4th and 6, we gotta go for it. We're too close for a punt, too far for a field goal. We're gonna find Green and we pick up the first down. Now I'm using the default roster from NCAA 14, which was the year that Florida State would go to their last national championship where they would lose to Auburn. So I figured, hey, let's rewrite two wrongs, why not? Anyways, man, the final in this one is 28-23. There will be no rematch this year because, as you see, Florida is not as good as they were back in 1996. But for us, we're going to go to that ACC championship game. And as you saw, we win it 34-20. And ironically enough, it was versus Virginia Tech. And Virginia Tech was the last team that they beat to win the national title, right? Am I right about that? I believe I'm right about that. And, of course, Peter Warrick had a phenomenal game. So with ACC champs, Randy Moss, the big boss, Belenikoff Award winner, man, had himself a season. He had himself a season. Then my boy Nick O'Leary. Is he still in the league? Is he still in the league? He might still be in the league. I'm not sure. He won a Mackey Award. We got an offense lineman win the offense lineman award. We had Dent and not Peter Warrick win the returner of the year, which sucks, but you know what? It is what it is. We are just racking up trophies, and then I don't know what that trophy is for at all. Let me know down in the comments section below. All I do know is that we're going to the national championship to take on Nebraska. Two old school dynasties, man. Florida State and Nebraska. It gets no better. I mean, it does. Like, you know, Ohio State, Michigan. There's some other ones I can think of. Florida State, Miami, Florida State. I mean, but Florida State, Nebraska should be a fantastic one as well. As we find Randy Moss early and often making plays. That is going to be a first down. Give the ball to Warrick Dunn, and Warrick Dunn picks up 7. Second down and 3. Go right back to Warrick Dunn. Picks up 2. So on 3rd and 1, we got Peter Warrick. Look at those hands. Look at those hands. Doing his thing. 2nd down and 9. That is going to be caught by Randy Moss. Breaks one tackle, breaks another, and gets dragged down at a 30-yard gain inside the 5. 1st and goal. Give it to Warrick Dunn. Well done, Warrick, as we get to the end zone. Let's jump to the second quarter, you guys. And in the second quarter, we are up 14-7 after our defense allowed a touchdown, and they got a touchdown themselves. Some bad boys on the defensive side of the ball, Florida State, you know. Anyways, man, Warrick Dunn's going to take that thing up the gut, and he's going to have a nice little game. Then on 3rd and 4, going to find Warrick Dunn again. Look at the moves in the secondary. Get off of me, he says. 1st down and 10, Busby over the middle, going to find Warrick, and Warrick gets this thing upfield, man. Warrick, Randy Moss, and Warrick Dunn will all be Heisman finalists in their own right. That's pretty impressive, bruh. And now they're all on the field at one time. I mean, Florida State, y'all could have had a team to remember forever. Like, forever. Anyways, man, we're up 21-14 now. We're going to find Calvin Benjamin. Look at good old Calvin Benjamin making an appearance. Do your thing, bruh. 1st down. Looking downfield, get away from the pressure, and we're going to find my man Peter Warrick for a gain of 7. 3rd down and 3. Look at the precision passing. He almost got hit as soon as he let that thing go, but finds Peter Warrick for a 23-yard strike. We're not done. Look at the separation by Peter Warrick. Oh, my gosh. In 1996, he was a redshirt freshman. He could have been in that DeSean Jackson type of role next to a Randy Moss, man. I mean, my goodness. And he had work done too. This team would have been crazy, bro. Now, we wouldn't score any more points in the game. The final score would be 28-21. But hey, we are national champs. That's all that matters. I wanted to give some Florida State fans some joy because I know this season so far hasn't gone your way. But hey, maybe you guys can still make a run at possibly winning the ACC. Crazier things have happened. Anyways, work done. He is the player of the game. We got that national championship. I'm gone, you guys. If you guys want to see another one of these videos, it could be NCAA. It could be Madden. I mean, basketball season coming around the corner, but I might just keep it football. I might just keep it with the pigskin, if you know what I mean. But I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope the rest of your day is the best of your day. Not the best of your day, but the best of your day. And I'm gone. Peace, love.
Awesome.